Okay, so now that we've gone over all the major components of the NetLogo interface and how to create basic models, we're actually going to create our very first model. And for this, we're going to use a model in our game that's quite interesting. Kind of talks a little bit about emergent properties as well. So that's why we're gonna start with this one. And the game is called Heroes and Cowards, or at least that's what Uri Wilensky and I call it. It was used by the Fratelli Theater Group in the 1980s and 90s to kind of explore emergent phenomenon. And it was presented at a conference called Embracing Complexity in 1999. Normally, to play the game, you need a group of people, and you actually have people actually act it out. And here on the screen, you can see a couple of examples of that. And I'm hoping to get some video, actually, that I can link to you guys later that shows some examples of how the game actually played. But it's a very simple game. You get a group of people together, and essentially, you have everyone choose an enemy and a friend randomly from the group. And then there are two stages to the game. In the first stage of the game, you're going to place your friend between you and the enemy. And that's called the coward stage, because you're trying to use your friend to shield you from the enemy. And in the second stage of the game, you're going to place yourself and between your friend and the enemy. And that's called the hero stage, because you're trying to protect the enemy, trying to protect the friend from the enemy, right? And what's interesting about this, as we'll see as we build this model, is that this creates very different patterns of behavior. That even though the rules are almost identical between the heroes and the cowards phases of the game, the outcomes are quite dramatically different. And so we're gonna explore that. But you don't really need to know the emergent outcomes, right, to actually build the model. So let's build the model first, and then we'll explore the outcomes. Okay, so we're going to start building our model. And to start building our model, the first thing we know we need to do is get some turtles in the world. So let's go over to the code tab, and we'll start creating a place for the turtles to come in. And let me blow this up a little bit so it's easier to read. So we can do this by doing, you know, always writing the stubs that I always write right off the bat whenever I start a model, which is to set up and to go, right? And then for the setup, the first command we almost always have is clear all, as we talked about, which basically starts the model over again and destroys any of the variables and the turtles that are there. And then the last command in setup is almost always reset ticks, which we discussed, which basically sets the tick counter back to zero and tells NetLogo that you're ready to start start the model running, right? And then one thing I often do, depending upon the way I'm doing it, is I ask the patches to set their patch color to white. Essentially, this just creates a blank slate for the world to exist in. And also, by the way, it's easier to print a image that is some turtles on a white background than it is turtles on a black background, because white paper is white. So if you're printing out the results, it's much easier to do if you have a white background. And then, by the way, I like to start to comment my code as I'm writing it, so I'm going to write a comment here that this is a blank background, right? And then the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create a set of turtles. And I often don't like to go too far before I check to make sure my code's running, so I'll hit the little check syntax tab. Everything seems okay. I'll go back to the interface, and I'll just type the word setup. And it seems like it's doing what I expected to do at this point. And I could do some more in-depth debugging, but this is a good place to kind of start to add some more code. And one thing I'm going to want to do right away is add some buttons. So I'll add a button for setup, and I will add a button for go. And of course, the go button, we're going to want to make a forever button. So we'll just click that forever button display right now, right? And now if I hit setup, I can just run that code again and again. So we're not quite done with the setup code. If you think about it from the perspective of the heroes and cowards model, right, we want to create a bunch of agents that are roaming around a room or a space, essentially, right? And so the first thing we got to do is we just got to give them some initial places to exist. And so we're going to set their their XY coordinates to random XY coordinates to begin with, right? And now, you know, we can go ahead and go back over, and we can now see that the model creates them in random locations, right? Now, one of the other things we mentioned is that there are going to be two phases, right? There's going to be a hero phase and a coward phase. And so at this point, we might as well start to think about what those two phases might look like. So one way that we can obviously easily do this is to have the turtles actually change colors to indicate what phase they're in. And by doing that, we have a more visual representation of what's going on. So we're going to set the turtles what we're going to call personalities, which is whether or not they're a hero or a coward. And we're going to do that based upon a chooser, which we haven't created yet, from the interface. And we're just going to call it personalities. It's going to be the global variable that controls this. And we're going to check to see if personality equals cowards, then we're going to set the color to blue, right? And if personalities equals heroes, we will set the color to red, right? And again, we'll just quickly check the syntax, and it's going to tell us nothing named personalities has been defined, and that's correct. Often we start creating code before we create all the variables to back it up. So one thing we might do is go over to the interface tab and create a chooser for personalities. All right, so we'll name it personalities, and we'll give it the values, the choices of either cowards or heroes, which is what we're checking for in our code, right? So now, if we go back to the code, it'll say okay. And now we can see if this works, right? Because we know that if we set it to cowards, then the turtle should set their color to blue. So we do that, and sure enough, it sets the color to blue. And if we change it to heroes and we hit setup, it sets the color to red. So that seems to be working correctly. Now, the last thing we need each turtle to do, if you remember the initial startup phase from the game, is we need each of the turtles, the players, to choose a friend and an enemy. So we can have them choose the friend and enemy in the group, right? And so there's some quick ways to do this. We can have them set friend one of other turtles, and set enemy one of other turtles, right? And so we're just choosing randomly, and it'll set it up. So you'll notice that when I hit check, of course, it says nothing named friend and enemy is defined. Those aren't standard turtle properties. So we have to go up to the top and add these in as turtle properties as we described in the last few lectures. So turtle's own, friend, and enemy. And now when we hit setup, it'll be there. We can now hit setup again, and you know nothing has changed because these are happening internally. But what we can do is we can inspect one of the turtles and look at it, and sure enough, this is turtle 38 that I'm inspecting. And there's a variable for turtle 28 and turtle 64 being separate. Okay, so let's pause there. Now that we have the setup routine pretty much done, and we will start working on how to actually make this model work in the next talk.